Hi everybody, live from Hollywood Productions Amsterdam. Welcome to another Corona Diaries live chat. Today's guest is Jeremy Jackson from Baywatch, Hobie Buchanan. So let's call US and invite Jeremy. Jeremy Jackson, Amsterdam is calling. Jeremy.
Hey,
how are you?
Good, brother. How you doing?
Fine. Happy 4th of July.
Yes, my man.
Nice to see you. Just a small connection. Wi-Fi connection. So let's wait and get him back.
Thank you.
There's I think small Wi-Fi connection.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Yes, I hear you.
Okay, good.
So again, happy 4th of July.
Happy 4th of July, brother. You're in Amsterdam?
Yes, I'm in Amsterdam, and here's Peter. Peter is assisting me today with your Q&A.
Hey, man.
Wonderful.
With his Baywatch.
You have Baywatch shirts.
His Baywatch shirt, and I am David Hasselhoff.
I love it, man. You guys, you always take such good care of me, man. I appreciate that.
And look at behind us.
Oh, my man. You know what? I shouldn't be surprised because you always go all the way for me and for everybody that you work with. So I shouldn't be surprised, but I'm very thankful, man. That looks great back there.
And you look good.
Hey, man, I'm in Austin, Texas right now. It's beautiful outside. I'm going to take you guys for a tour on the lake here. It's so warm and so gorgeous out here. I got to show you guys this beautiful landscape.
That's really cool. And Murat is there.
Maybe we'll have to do a live rescue. You never know.
Yeah. And Jeremy, Mark joined us from Istanbul. He said hello to you.
Actually, Murat, what's up, man?
And here, actually, we go back first to the journey. We go with our time machine and we see you because you were in all over Europe with your tour in Baywatch times. And let's see how your fans, they are crazy about you.
You guys are crazy.
And let's see.
Kijk even hier, waar het om gaat.
Jeremy.
Jos, wat zeg je?
Lekker ding is.
Vind je het een lekker ding? Yeah. Maar even
zelf naar de luister. Hij is zo mooi en knap in. Ja, ik zeg gewoon dat hij knap is en hij speelt goed de rol.
Hij zit nu te kijken, want hij zit te ontbijten. Hij zit nu te kijken. Wat wil je tegen hem zeggen?
Dat ik van hem.
Wat?
Dat ik van hem hou en dat hij zijn vriendin met zijn vriendin moet uitmaken.
Oh, dat is pittig.
Wow, look at the crowd. Oh, they came for Jeremy Jackson.
Oh my gosh, that's funny, man.
Wow, now also actually, Peter said this is in Holland. It is, everybody speak Dutch over there and you can see the crowd. They are just trying to get signatures from you actually here. So that was really interesting, you know, as you see. So that was really cool, what we see.
And some crazy also times. Crazy, amazing times.
Jawel, onze Vraag Maar Raakgast heet Jeremy!
Yeah, sure, thanks.
Okay, you also have it inside out.
Yeah, it's inside out, of course.
Yeah.
Yes.
You all do that in America, huh?
All the time.
It's cool.
It's a new trend.
Hey, I still have that hat. I still have that hat.
Wow. That is really cool, you know. How you were treated, the child star, you know. So that was really cool, actually.
You know that hat that I was wearing?
Yeah.
I still have it.
Can I see? Wait. Let's see. Wow.
Yeah. But they used to make me put a sticker. See, the tape is over Adidas because they didn't want me to show Adidas.
Yeah?
What was that? Adidas?
Yeah.
But that is really cool, you know. So that is I like it very much, actually. And here also, I want to see also you sing there. So I just want to see the singing. So that is also I think really cool how you sing at that time. Just from the Tele Kids, actually, we have a very special footage. And let's hear Jeremy Jackson in European concert. Whoa. People are crazy about you here, you know. I can see it now. Listen, also the footage, the continue of the footage.
I still know all the dance moves.
Yeah? Look at you, man. Everybody is crazy about you. You can see. You know? You are just signing some autographs and, you know, it's crazy. Very, very good, actually. You see?
You know, my dream when I was a little kid was to be like Michael Jackson, you know? So to be there with that, it was a dream come true for me.
Wow.
For me, Michael Jackson too, because I danced Michael Jackson too when I was younger.
Yeah.
Hello. So for me,
yeah. Of course, that is really cool. Look at him.
Shamo.
Shamo. And Jeremy, tell about your CDs, actually. How many music CDs you did? How many albums?
Yeah, well, you know, we had two top 10 hits. I did, I think, 3 or 4 singles. We did 2 albums. One of my songs got me inducted into the World Music Hall of Fame. I think I debuted at number 3 on the Billboard charts in Holland. You know, they still play the song on the radio to this day. My song was the theme song for Ajax, and you know, it was amazing. Adidas was my sponsor, and so I got lots of free clothes, and I got to travel all around the world, and thousands of amazing fans. It was an amazing, wild time in my life, you know?
Wow. Yeah, we see it, you know? So it was amazing, you know? So, I mean, because of Baywatch, you started, and you know how it came, you know? Like, you were, because from 1991 till 1999, all the seasons of Baywatch, from the second season, you go on. So it was really, really good, actually, how you did. Actually, I heard a story about Leonardo DiCaprio.
Uh-huh.
That he was also casted for he want to do the hobby to play the hobby role. But what happened? Yep. Tell us.
Well, look, I over 1,000 kids auditioned for the role that I got. Leonardo DiCaprio was one of them, but there was a lot of other. Jonathan Brandis. I don't know if you remember Jonathan Brandis.
Yeah.
Sequest, I think. Will Horniff, who was on the Lassie show. Everybody tried out for that role. All the child actors tried out for that role, and I just happened to be the one that got it, you know. And I definitely, you know, I did beat out Leonardo DiCaprio. I think he might have been a year or two older than me, and they wanted somebody that could age with the show, and you know, just that's how the entertainment industry goes, man. You just roll the dice. You just show up and see what happens.
Yeah, and here's your father in the show.
Yeah.
Mr. Buchanan and his son.
That's right.
Look at you
and
guys.
And Sunday best.
Yeah.
All dressed up, looking fancy.
And the team was good. Here is Billy Warlock and Erica. And actually, that was also a good part from season 2, actually. So that was also really cool. So tell us a little bit about how it was in the set, because you started there with amazing, you know, and all around the world, everybody watching you, and of course your father. It was
you know, a dream come true, man. David Hasselhoff was my hero already. I grew up watching Knight Rider every day. I loved Knight Rider. I already was at the beach every day surfing. You know, I have a single mom. You know, she raised me on her own, and you know, Mitch Buchanan was a single father. So, you know, to step into a role, hanging out on the beach all day, surfing, you know, and pretending to be this kid with a single parent was not hard for me. It was a very natural fit. It felt right. It was meant to be. And, you know, I had the time of my life. I got to do so much fun stuff, and traveling with David all over Europe doing music. You know, that's Charisma Carpenter from The Expendables. You know her from, what else? Buffy the Vampire. Is it Buffy the Vampire Slayer?
Yeah.
No, the other, yeah.
Angel. We had the Angel and
Angel. Buffy. Angel. Yes, yes. Yeah. And I forget his name right now. You know his name?
I forget it also. Angel.
I forget this guy's name, but.
Boronez? David Boronez?
No, this kid. He's a big actor. I think he was in Camp Nowhere, the movie Camp Nowhere. And I believe he was on Seventh Heaven for many years. So I got to work with a lot of actors who did very well in their careers later on. You know, Michelle Williams was my love interest. You know her from Brokeback Mountain, Marilyn Monroe movie.
Yeah.
Heath Ledger's baby's mom. And, you know, Nikki Cox from Las Vegas TV show. A lot of very famous people were on Baywatch. We worked with Oprah Winfrey on Baywatch. She came down. We did an episode on her show. I got along very well with Oprah. She invited me to come back on her show. So I went Oprah Winfrey twice.
You were there twice, two times.
Yeah. Tyra Banks show, you know. So a lot of amazing things happened. It was a big time in the 90s. You know, you had O.J. Simpson. You had the riots. You had, you know, so many things were happening in the world during the world needed, they needed sun. They needed beautiful people having fun and saving lives. And, you know, I think very interestingly, like right now with COVID and everything that's going on, it's a perfect time to bring that happiness back. Yeah, don't you think? The beauty, the happiness, the passion, saving lives, taking risks. We should all, it's time. It's time. And we're actually filming a Baywatch documentary right now with an amazing production crew. It's going to be like nothing you've ever seen about Baywatch. We got Kelly Slater in it. We got Carmen Electra. Yasmin Bleeth is in our documentary. She's coming back. She's coming out of hiding. Yasmin Bleeth. No one has seen her or talked to her in years. She's doing the documentary, and we're about 75% done. So it's going to be a really, really big deal.
Okay. And this is, I want to show when you are talking, because I couldn't show. Let's see something from the show. Actually, the Tyra Banks, you said. Let's see. Remember the Tyra Banks?
Yes, of course.
I have a question for Jeremy. There were so many hot girls on the set of Baywatch. Did you ever sneak a peek at any of them changing?
Oh, my gosh.
You didn't have to sneak a peek. Many times, actually.
Really?
You'd have to, the girls would have to, like, go run to change before their next scene, and we would share these trailers that were identical, and I'd be like, okay, she has to change. 5, 4, 3. Bathing suit's probably coming down.
Whoa. Always interesting, you know, you have always good answers, you know, for the people, so it's really cool. And also, you were hosting in a lot of events, parties. Actually, I see a lot of events. Let's see which parties you were involved also all around the world. Jeremy Jackson parties.
I think we're ready to meet Mr. Crazy Stud. Come on out here, Jeremy Jackson.
Let's go for a ride. They know you're somebody when you're driving this car.
Coming up, number 20, dropping 3 spots, Lady Gaga with Just Dance.
A red bike.
What's up, everybody, and welcome to Functional Fitness. We're going to push our limits today, break the boundaries down, and that's what it's all about.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino in Vegas, I've had a great time. Thank you, Ron Rice, Sterling Rice, Jack Walker, and, of course, my lovely co-host, Erica Johnson. Thank you, everybody, and good night.
I'm seeing so many dogs running across the street lately that don't have homes.
Yeah, you got to spade and neuter your cat or dog.
Hey, I'm Jeremy Jackson, and this is Hot Stuff. I got 4 sizzling stories for you.
Hey, everybody, I'm Jeremy Jackson, and I'm here to welcome you to your beautiful new casa. The next song on my playlist is Michael Jackson, Don't Stop Tingling.
Health, wealth, and fitness. I'm Jeremy Jackson. Manifest. It's the happening. I actually have 130 stitches in my forehead trying to spin like him, and I fell on my cup.
130?
Yeah, right from all the way in my eyebrow all the way up.
Wow.
So I've paid the price to be a Michael Jackson fan. On this week's show, we're going to tell you how to get in a car under $20,000 with 400 horsepower under the hood.
Great, 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 huh? I mean, all the time, parties, events, everything.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times.
Daddy's back! Woo!
Congratulations again. You know, you did a good job, man. So that is really, really impressive, actually. You know, I like it very much.
Daddy's back, Baro. Daddy's back.
So, and tell us, how was the parties that time? Because you were also the face and you were also all the time with Cristiano Dege, actually, Ed Hardy.
Yeah.
You were an Ed Hardy guy. With
him. Yeah, Ed Hardy, Cristiano Dege, Von Dutch. You know, we did over 200 parties in, I believe, 15 countries and 36 states. We traveled all over the world. We did the hugest events from Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week with Paris Hilton and the Osbournes to London Fashion Week finale party at Crystal Nightclub. We worked with Young Jock, Chingy. We worked with Birdman, Lil Wayne. We did so many parties with so many big celebrities, and people were just going crazy. The clothing was amazing at the time. I believe Christian Odege is relaunching his brand. Unfortunately, he passed away. That's my godfather. Yeah. Rest in peace, Christian Odege. He was an angel, man. He was my guardian angel, and I think he still is. So we might be doing something with a new brand from Christian Odege's legacy.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. And look at this, Jeremy. Actually, let's remember a few parties of them.
Okay.
In a way, once my job is done on the film, it's really none of my business.
We're talking about something else.
Ladies and gentlemen,
keep your mind on the movie. Every time I turn around, it's a lot of fun. And
I'm sorry.
That's all right. Well,
aren't you a little curious about how the work looks that you're doing?
No.
This is irresponsible.
Ed Hardy, whoa.
Yeah, man. We amazing models, break dancers, skateboarders. It was a very, very next level, man. I see now a lot of fashion shows are using a lot of the things that we created. You know, people weren't treating fashion shows like a party. You know, when you do a fashion show and you're showing off your clothing, it's not just about the clothing, it's about the lifestyle behind the clothing. Yeah. And interestingly enough, my years with Ed Hardy creating lifestyle, you know, creating a brand, actually helped me a lot in my new business with Pachamama CBD. I have a shirt right here. So I am now the head of lifestyle development for a company called Pachamama CBD. We do full spectrum hemp extracts, spectrum hemp extract that helps pain, anxiety, sleep, depression. So because I love fitness, because I love health and wellness, and because I have so much experience with developing the lifestyle, you know, this person, not everybody's going to wear Ed Hardy. Not everybody is going to wear Christian Odege. Not everybody's going to want the most expensive small batch pure CBD. They're going to want something cheap that looks like it comes from a doctor. Ours is not cheap, and it comes from Mother Nature. It's not a medical thing. It's a natural thing. So creating the relationships with the right and sponsoring the right athletes and, you know, the proper education is something that I'm very used to thanks to Christian Odege and Ed Hardy. So, it wasn't just back then. We're still doing that. We're still developing the lifestyle.
Wow. I just show a few also what you are talking about the fitness, about your look at you also, your body, how you.
Well, you gotta show the final transformation, man. You know.
Yeah.
It's
coming.
The before and afters.
And look at you.
That was a good photo shoot. I got access to all those photos if you want more of those. Those are great ones.
Yeah, for sure. And you remember this photo actually. From a special
of
party,
course.
We're going to party.
Yes.
You were singing, you were doing great, and all the Romania, actually, they come to you and they said, Dvorul, he's great, 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 awesome. And let's see also how you were singing in the nightclub. Everybody was watching.
Oh no.
That will be really cool, actually. I will show you in a few seconds, actually.
Okay.
That will be amazing, you know. So
very good.
So, and how are your days passing, by the way? Everything is okay with you?
Everything's wonderful, you know. I take very good care of myself as far as my nutrition and my vitamins and drinking water. I have a very strong immune system, you know. Okay. So I'm not worried for myself. But, you know, of course I have family that are older and, you know, my sister is not in perfect health. So there are people in my immediate circle that are in jeopardy. And I know that a lot of people around the world have been infected, you know, not just a lot of people have died. A lot of people have lost their jobs. A lot of people have lost family members, have you. It is a global issue that is so catastrophic and disappointing. And, you know, But I actually am involved with a company that has a cure.
Yeah.
And we'll be announcing more information about that very soon. We're working on probably one of the biggest pay-per-view boxing specials that has ever happened. I can't mention his name, but he's making a comeback. You've probably heard about it. And we'll be announcing the cure probably in the next couple of months.
Nice.
So it's a terrible time, but it's also a very exciting time because there is a solution to this problem and it's not as hard as everybody thinks.
Okay.
So we're really, really excited, man.
I like
to fix problems. You know, I don't like to dwell on them. I like to focus on the solution.
Of course. And let's see now, we have the footage. My friend found the footage and let's see how you were singing and all Romanian people watching you. Club, actually, yeah, everybody say it is cool. We get a lot of comments. If you see the club now, actually, evening, yeah, what we did, it was crazy.
Good times. I still have the shirt. Remember the shirt that guy made me, the custom shirt?
Yeah.
I still have it. I love it.
Of course. So that was a really impressive time when we had all the time together, of course, because we had, I think, 4 or 5 trips international with you, you know, so that was really interesting. And another amazing day. Do you remember this? Look.
Oh yeah, you know.
Oh my gosh, what did you
do? We went crazy.
There must be something happened there, and let's see what happened. Actually, I want to show that. And if we find it, yes, we find the footage, and it's coming. And let's remember, that is really crazy day, actually. People are looking at you, and what's going on?
You know, you can always count on me to cause some problems, you know what I mean?
I believe that was just water, so it doesn't matter. Funny.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, Jeremy Jackson, always funny with you, you know, so it was really cool.
Topaz, the singer. Yeah?
Always exciting, always with a big thrill journey, you know, always with love and
looking forward to much more fun. We got a lot more trouble to get in.
Yeah. And now, And now also some of the new the fans, new people came just into the chat actually, and they just want to talk a little bit about Baywatch. And I want to just show your Baywatch time actually, which is I think it's really cool. Let's see how you were. Erica. Nicole, David Charvet. Here is Pamela. And here's Jeremy Jackson.
Uh-oh.
So, and everybody, everybody loved you from Baywatch as hobby, you know. Do you have any interesting memories, you know? Like, did you have any, something happen in Dangerous in the set? Something very, you know, like, because you did many seasons.
Of course, man. Of course. All kinds of crazy stuff happened.
But do you remember any big one?
Tracy Bingham. I really actually had to rescue her once. She was drowning. Her hair was in her face. She couldn't get her hair out of her face. And her hair was in her mouth with water. She tried to breathe and she was choking and she was drowning. And I was the only one that noticed. I had to rescue her.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. You know, when I worked with Giant Gonzalez, Jorge Gonzalez, the wrestler,
yeah,
it was a very amazing time. Him and I became very close friends, and he was such a sweet man, a good man. You know, he was 7 feet tall.
Yeah.
It was an incredible time. You know, I got injured many times. You know, sometimes I had to go out into the ocean in very big waves, and you know, I broke my nose on a surfboard one time. You know, many times.
And these scenes, you can see these scenes also. You were like drawing here on this one with Nicole.
Well, you know, Nicole was my fantasy for many years since I was a kid, and I finally got to date her right after that we filmed this movie. Her and I became boyfriend and girlfriend for maybe at least a year, maybe more, and that was my childhood dream come true. She's an amazing person, a gorgeous woman, and she's one of my closest friends to this day.
Wow.
Yeah.
So it became reality.
Yes.
From the TV show became reality.
Keep dreaming. It becomes reality. You got to believe it, baby.
Yeah. And now everybody can see Nicole and Jeremy. They were in the Baywatch. One of those. This is one of the seasons. I don't know which season now. So we can see them actually. So.
Yep.
I think this is one of the last seasons, huh?
This was the reunion movie, the Baywatch Hawaiian Wedding. This was the last, original cast, full cast that we did. Baywatch Hawaii kept going, but this was different. This was the regular Baywatch show, but filmed one time in Hawaii.
Yeah, the exclusive one.
TV movie.
So at the moment, actually, Baywatch is all over the world again. They came back with Amazon Prime remastered.
Yeah, yeah.
And you said the documentary also, you are busy with it, huh?
Yeah, the documentary is going to be big, man. You guys are going to be blown away. There's a lot of stuff that nobody knows. There's a lot of things, backstory, stories, relationships, friendships, betrayal. You know, a lot of stuff about the time. You know, the things that were going on in the 90s, the state that the world was in, and how we actually impacted the state of the world with our show. I think everybody's going to be blown away. This is going to breathe new life into the show. This is going to educate the younger generation. Wow. So all of those parents out there that grew up loving Baywatch, all you got to do is show your kids this documentary and they'll fall in love with it just like you did.
Yeah, good, man. So that's also good. Even though in all America, actually, you know, they were all talking about you when the Baywatch was there. You know, the episodes were showing about you. For example, also this one, what the fans asked me, you know, look, also this one is also all about you.
On the next Baywatch.
My name's Obi. I've seen you around. You are a really good surfer.
How far would you go to impress?
as a girl.
This is so cool. I would give anything to learn how to fly.
Which rules would you break?
Oh, no. The hang glider's gone.
What risks would you take?
Don't do it!
Got a couple of kids in a hang glider at Point Furman. We're gonna check it out. She better be worth it.
Dad!
Obie! On the next Baywatch.
I love it.
Yeah. Again, you see, you were there everywhere.
That's right.
Yeah. So tell us also, okay, we are finished with Baywatch part, and now we are talking about karate and your martial arts life and how is it going, you know, with jiu-jitsu. So you are doing a lot of those, you know, martial arts stuff, actually.
Yeah, man. Look, Brazilian jiu-jitsu is a part of me, you know, it's in my heart. It's a wonderful way to gain discipline, self-confidence. It's a wonderful way to stay in shape. Also, self-defense. You know, you become empowered by humility, by humbling yourself and realizing that there's always more to learn and you're never going to be the best. There's always going to be somebody better than you, you know. And yes. Sometimes with life, I want to be the best, or I want to be perfect, or do the best job. And it's okay to not be the best. It's okay to just do your best. And jiu-jitsu has taught me that, and it gives you a very quiet and confidence. But you know, also the martial art is amazing, and there's so much to learn. So I started doing tournaments about 6 or 7 years ago now, and yeah. I've won 7 tournaments. I'm a purple belt now, so I have 7 gold medals and a few silvers. Wow. And a few 1 bronze, I think, 2 silver, and 7 gold. And I like to push myself, man. I like to find my limits and see what I'm capable of. So also Muay Thai, kickboxing, you know, I love all as well. So, you know, it's a great way to push yourself and, you know, getting good at this stuff, becoming a certified personal trainer, becoming a nutritionist, a clinical nutritionist. That was at my wedding reception. David pulled out Kit Car for us. But learning all of this stuff. Yeah, it was pretty cool. Learning all of this stuff, you can teach more people, you know? Yeah, yeah, that's why I'm in Texas right now eating barbecue like that every day.
And this is from last week, I think.
No, is it making me fat? Am I fat?
Look at you.
You're not supposed to eat barbecue. It's meat makes you fat, right?
And this is your Corona look?
That's my Jesus look.
Okay. Because we always say, is it a Corona look? You know, when you couldn't share.
This is my Corona look, yes. So, yeah, it's only getting better from here, baby.
Yeah, I mean, you are always looking good. Your shape is always good, you know.
You guys want to see where I'm at right now? You want to see the beauty?
Yes, please.
Look at this. Watch this.
Right. Look at this. Wow. So now it's a live tour from Jeremy Jackson in Austin.
Awesome.
This is I'm very jealous because normally I run also in the park.
Yeah.
I want to run like that in America. Not only in Holland, you know.
Wow, it's wonderful. River right here, man. Wow. All these restaurants right on the river. People kayaking. You know. It's so hot. It's beautiful.
Even kind
of absolutely beautiful. Wow. Out here.
That's really cool. I like it.
It's very
look at
nice
the weather. It's very nice.
Very nice. Very
good. Yeah. Sweating.
Very nice there. Wow.
Wow.
I'm jealous because I want to run also.
Look at the weather, man. It's really cool. So how is Austin, by the way? It's a, I think, big city in Texas.
Big city in Texas. Amazing food. Very nice people. Lots of water, lakes, hikes, waterfalls. Yeah, a good business. Affordable rent and home prices. It's a great place to be, man. Wow. I don't live here. I come here every summer because I love it. The food is amazing.
That's beautiful.
Yep.
So at the moment we show Jeremy Jackson with the Baywatch cast with David and Parker Stevenson and David Chokachi. So let's see a few more things from him. And you see me and Jeremy. Actually, this is also almost more than 10 years.
Yep.
10 years. Oof. Yeah.
Hard to believe, huh?
Wow, look at the time goes up, yeah?
Sure does.
And this is with Mark, actually.
Yeah.
You can see also another picture of us.
You like my shorts?
Oh, leopard.
Yeah.
Wow. You remember this food?
Oh, so good. Oh, let's go. Can we go back there?
Yeah, look at the meat. Look at the,
you promise?
The size of
you
the meat.
Promise we could go back there?
Yeah, man. Wow.
That was the best.
And this is with Rami's, actually.
You know I like my meat.
Yeah.
No carbs.
No carbs.
Yeah.
And are you cooking also? Or?
Yeah, you know, I'm a certified personal chef, nutrition chef. So I have a couple very high-end people that I care about, really. You know, cooking is hard work. It's not easy. You know, to cook for somebody for 1 week takes 9 hours. 9 hours of hard work, and everything is prepackaged. So really, I don't cook for many people unless I truly love them and know they need to be in better health, because I can't find many chefs that are as specific as I am with superfoods, with nutrition, with calories, with holistic healing foods, like the herb, the herb liqueur, remember?
Yeah.
Like in Croatia, the herb liquor with the, it's medicine, right? You can drink things and eat things that are medicine. So I like helping people with the information that I have to help them.
Wow. And Jeremy, you I think you did many things, by the way, because now my friend says, oh, I see him also in Rio. What is Rio? I said, not in Rio de Janeiro, but in Las Vegas, Rio. So even you were in, I think, in Chippendales.
they couldn't pay me enough, man.
I see, you know,
the only
Chippendales
problem.
Promotion. Actually, the promotion of Chippendales. What I see.
Yep.
As a guest, here I see again Jeremy Jackson. All over, you know. And do you again plan to make some music again, actually? Because I heard some stories in Holland, in Europe. They
said
coming back with the music.
We need to do this, man. I do. I have some new music. I haven't been focusing on it, but I do have a DJ that really wants to remix my song, You Can Run, but we're having a very hard time finding the original files, the original music.
Okay.
Because Edel, my former record label, they closed down. So it's not impossible, but I'm going to need your help. We're going to have to do some research when I get out there.
Of course, we can do it, because your music was really great. Even though, look, when you were here, this is sold everywhere, actually. We hear it all the time.
Yeah.
This music. Toby. Very nice, very nicely made, actually. On those years, even, you know, like, you can see how you make your album, your video clip, even when you were very young, you know.
That's right, man. It's I was born with it, man. It was in me naturally. Singing, dancing, entertaining, you know, music, you know, comedy. It's just it was my passion from a very early age.
That's really nice, really nice. And actually, let's see now, we are almost finished. We are almost done with the parts, what we talked, actually. And I want to see any questions. Actually, we have many messages, many, Jeremy, I don't know if you saw it. More than 100 messages already came to Instagram, and also Messenger, almost 50 plus. So I'm just checking what we have.
Jungle Man, Tarzan.
Yeah.
Underwear.
People are all, give compliments to you, actually. Very sexy, good look, jungle man, great memories. You were so good in Baywatch.
Thank you, thank you.
You are great, Jeremy. Where are you, Jeremy? Jeremy is in Austin. This is a cool walk down memory lane. He is very handsome from Sharon.
Thank you,
and
Sharon.
Brom and Sharon also, they sent messages from...
Oh, Brom! Let's do new pictures.
Yes, Brom Heyman's also waiting for you here. We see, yeah, Pasquale, ciao. So I get messages. Also, let's see, you, many of your friends actually from Los Angeles, from LA.
Awesome. Your good. Fitness Thanks coach. For tuning in, guys. Thank you.
Yeah, your fitness coach. Oh. Sent you
yeah, Christian. Message. Christian, probably.
Exactly.
Nice.
Peter, also, you can look if you have interesting questions. We can read.
It's too bright. It's too bright in the sun. I can't see my phone.
They ask about your new, anything comes up, any new TV series. They're asking. Any,
you know, I'm producing a documentary right now regarding our cure for COVID. I can't say too much about it, but it's a natural approach. And we're using a very special process that allows the human body to do what it needs to do naturally with a device, a medical device. So we're going to be doing some really big stuff with a big boxing match, with a big cryptocurrency launch, with a big medical device breakthrough. And we're going to be doing a large scale nationwide search for the people who have been affected by this disease the most. And we're going to impact those people's lives in a major way. And we're going to provide some solution and healing. So, the entertainment industry, being on TV, being famous, I don't really care about that stuff.
I know.
And if I make $1 million to be in a movie, or I make $500,000 and I help a million people, I'm one person. If I make less money, but I help one person, I'd rather take less money and help one person. I want to provide solution. I want to help people get over anxiety, pain, addiction, depression, mental health disorder. You know, we should really talk about the Imperfectly Perfect campaign and the work that I do with the Imperfectly Perfect campaign, breaking the stigma about speaking to mental health disorders or issues, whether it's depression, anxiety, there's so much stuff going on with trauma, and people are afraid to admit it. They're afraid to address it because they think they'll be judged and looked at. I suffer from mental health issues. I get crazy. I get depressed. I get anxiety. You know, I struggle with addiction, and, you know, I want to use drugs and alcohol to make myself feel different because my brain sometimes doesn't feel great. And so many people do. But when we admit it and when we join and we help each other out and we listen, that provides help. So the Imperfectly Perfect campaign, big shout out to them. I do have projects going on, but I'm more behind the scenes. I'm not going to be the star. I'm probably going to be finding the story that makes the movie great. You know, that's what I'm more interested in is people, you know, and the stories.
Exactly, man. And also, Peter is also actually busy with some of your magazines, because he was reading also Iron Man. You were in already 10 pages.
Yes, 10 pages in Iron Man.
That was amazing also.
I know how to get in shape. That's for sure. I know how to get buff.
Yes, man. So, yeah. Yeah, he's just looking
everywhere.
You are everywhere. Actually, we're just checking the Baywatch.
My magazine.
Your meet and greet flyers everywhere.
Yes, I remember that, of course.
Yeah. And how is Yolana and Taylor?
Mom and sister are doing good right now. I just spent some time with them last week. They're doing good. They're healthy and safe.
Also, give my greetings to them, of course. So it will be really cool to see them again.
Of course.
And then you get a lot of messages from Spain, actually, from Madrid, from Barcelona.
Yes. We got to go to Spain. We'll do some more things there. You saw what I did, right?
Yes. And Jeremy, Hina Sayetri, she says his workout classes were great. Very deep meditation and breakthrough.
Wonderful. Yes. We'll talk about the meditation later, but I got a very special when I come out there, we need to set up some meditation groups. I'm gonna heal some lives. I'm gonna touch some lives in a major way. But that's all for now.
I am sure after September, when everything is open, you know, because at the moment we had some difficulties with flights.
Of course.
And then I think after September, we will schedule something in Europe, and for sure you will visit everywhere. You will visit all Europe again.
Good. And I just want to tell people out there, you know, I know that a lot of lives have been negatively impacted with COVID, and staying at home, watching the news, family members being sick. Maybe you got sick. Maybe family members have died or people close to you. You know, financially, we've been impacted. Our health has been impacted. Our security, and we've even had to endure a lot of pain, pain and suffering. Yeah. But I just want to encourage everybody out there to stay hopeful, to stay positive. Your mind can create your reality. Feel healthy, be healthy, know healthy. You don't want to get healthy, you are healthy. I am health. I am wellness. I am positivity, because you can overpower a lot with your mind. And even if the situation seems like it's never going to work out, you just keep taking one step in front of the other, knowing that it will work out. It's not working out right now. It's just because it's not working out yet, and that it will work out. It always does, and it always will. Nothing happens by mistake, and we didn't come this far in our lives to fail. So let's just keep holding hands. Let's just keep encouraging each other, staying positive. Drink lots of water, take your vitamins, get some exercise in your house, and just put a smile on your face even if you're scared, because we're going to do this together, all right?
Yes, man. I mean, good saying. You're great. You know, I mean, you are motivating.
We're going to knock COVID out. Bang, 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 bang.
And you are really a warrior. You are a soldier. You are our guy. We love you. And it was really great to have you. It is great to have you here. Again, you know, as our guest today with Corona Diaries live chat with Jeremy Jackson. So it was really cool.
Hey, I love all my fans, especially in Holland. Holland are my favorite people in the world. So I look forward to seeing you guys hopefully in September. And Varol, you're my brother. And I look forward to seeing all of your people, man. And I love what you're doing out there for everybody. You're really taking it to the next level. I see it.
Thank you very much. Always, you know. So we are doing our best and to entertain our, you know, followers, our fans, your fans, and make a good promotion, actually. And now already we get a lot of offers for you. Actually, they are waiting you in Holland and in Germany already.
Wonderful.
Let's go. And Murat gave very nice compliments to you, also.
Thanks, brother.
Yeah, everybody, actually. So it is really cool. And by the way, there is one question more we get from Corina Cadet. She says, which episode on Baywatch was your favorite? Your favorite Baywatch episode?
You know, it's tough, man. There's some episodes where all I had to do was ride around all day in a jet ski, you know. Those days were very, very fun because I just got to play around on a jet ski. But also there's some episodes where I got to kiss very beautiful girls. So, you know, like Michelle Williams. So it's hard to say for sure, but there's never a bad day at the beach. Never a bad day at the beach, you know?
Yeah. The beach is always good. Here is again with Baywatch picture of Jeremy. So, my friend, and you will swim today?
I'm going to go jump in the water right now, brother.
Okay, that's very cool, actually. So it was great to see you. It's great to see you. So we will do just 1 hour Corona selfie, actually. We do a selfie like this. Unfortunately, we have to do it this way. Let's see. Jeremy's on the back.
I got to try to... oh, shit.
What up, you doing? Jeremy Jackson, come to the selfie.
I made the alarm go off in the car. Hold on.
We're waiting. We are ready. We are ready anyway. We're born ready.
Hold on. Shoot. It's crazy, man. Corona selfie.
Corona selfie, and we are done. We are finishing the chat, and we are closing the chat after the selfie. Yeah. Okay, ready for a selfie. So let's do Mr. Jackson. Smile. Yeah. Yep. Thank you very much, Jeremy Jackson.
Okay, love you guys.
Okay, so again, happy 4th of July. And
yes.
Enjoy your day and stay safe. And we love you. and see you soon in Europe. We love,
love you guys. Yep. Bye bye.
All right. Bye bye. Take care. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. Thank you. He's amazing. He's a really cool dude and he's a good friend of mine. And always I'm having fun with him when he's around. So he's awesome. So looking forward to have him in Europe soon again after the flights are open, of course. So today's chat, it was with Jeremy Jackson, Hobby from Baywatch. And next week, we will see you soon with the new Corona Diaries live chats. Stay tuned. Have a nice weekend.
See you. Bye.
Bye-bye.